guys, it's Carrie. I hope you can hear me. My husband's got band practice going on in the background, so it's a little loud here. I wanted to show you the shoe that I'll be altering for the PopulArt group at your paper pantry. Every month it changes, you know, what you're going to alter. And this month we're doing an altered shoe, and my partner, well, actually we're doing a three-way swap because there was three signups, but I'll be sending to Stephanie. And this is the shoe I got, and believe it or not, there was one shoe at the thrift store, not two. So I actually had to buy one shoe. I was surprised they didn't just give it to me, because who else is gonna come in there crazy asking to buy one shoe, right? Especially this beautiful green one. So anyways, the way I'm planning on altering it is I'm gonna use some music paper, and I broke it down because when you, you know, paper is a little bit stiff when you first get it, and I'll show you how to do that. Anyways, this is how paper ends up looking after you break it down. Basically, you take the sheet of paper, you know, out of the book. This is like a, let me see if I can find it over here. I think it might have been this one. It's just like a, you know, from a thrift store. I think I paid like a quarter for it. So anyways, you're just gonna rip the sheet out. I'm sorry, I'm so shaky here. I lost my still camera, so I'm trying to use my phone to do this. But anyways, you're gonna take the sheet of paper and just, you know, crumple it up. And you're just trying to break down the fibers in it. So I crumpled mine up a couple times and spread it out. And then I sprayed it. For this one I used, I don't want it to have, you know, too much color, so I used this one. This one's the Teeth Chattering Teal in the Lindy Stamp Gang. It's just got a little tiny bit of color. I don't know if you can see it in there. It's just a little bit of blue sparkle in there, but mostly it's, you know, it's just a little tiny bit. It doesn't change the color of your paper. It just adds a little bit of sheen and just a little tiny bit of translucent color. So anyways, I sprayed that, and then I crumpled it up again just to break it down. So this is what I ended up with when I was done. And it's just a lot softer than the original paper. It won't tear as easily when you go to put it on your project. In my case, is the shoe. So just to prep this a little bit, I'm going to sand it down a little bit, just get some of the shiny off of it. And then I'm going to go ahead and use my favorite decoupage finish, which is this one, the Beacon Fast Finish Decoupage. It bonds and seals just like the Mod Podge does, but it's not as tacky and sticky, and it's a lot more liquidy than the other one. See, never tacky on there. So I just like this one a little bit better because it dries with a harder finish. So I'm gonna get started on that. See you in a bit. So you can see here that I've started on the shoe, and what I'm doing is just taking small pieces of the paper so it shapes around the shoe a little better, and I'm gonna go inside the edge just a little so that I can have that finished edge there. You just want to overlap until you get all of the surface finished. And I'm also not worrying about going over the bottom yet, so I'm going to go ahead and trim that off after it dries. I'll use a knife to do that. So I decided I'm going to go ahead and do the heel with the paper, and then I'm going to use some like twine to wrap around the bottom after it dries. And in the meantime, I just went ahead and lifted up the flaps and put some Mod Podge down in there, and then folded it down and held it down for a minute until it stayed. My jute and my hot glue gun to wind up the heel. And as you can see, I have a little bit of green spots showing through, but I'm just going to touch those up. And then I still have to figure out what to do with the bottom, but I wanted to show you this. I'm going to go ahead and refinish this inside with the paper as well, but I don't want to get it on this pad here. Also, if you want to make something different to go in here. I'm going to show you how to get it out if it's really stuck, like this one is. Just take your heat gun and heat it up just a little bit at a time. And that will loosen up the glue that's in there and make it a lot easier to get it out. Of course, it'd be a lot easier if I had two hands. So, and then when you get to the part where it's stuck again, just heat it up some more and pull that out. And just get it out in one piece. There's the inside. All this stuff, it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to cover it to inside where the pad will go back in with the pattern paper, with the music paper. I've done the inside of the shoe. If you can see that, I haven't put the liner back in yet. What I'm going to do next is just apply one more coat of the decoupage medium, and then I'm going to take a permanent marker or a Sharpie and just go along the edge here, you know, just crisp it up a little bit so it looks a little better than that. Just this is just where the paper stuck a little bit, so I'm going to clean that edge up. So then I'm going to take the liner and I'm going to trace it onto some burlap and make a new lining for the inside, and I'll probably just glue it to the top of this after I cut it out. We'll see how that works out, so we'll do that next. The burlap just a little bit bigger than the pad, and I'm about to glue it down. My finished shoe before the embellishments. You can see the inside, I did the burlap. Goes all the way down in there, and the inside is done. And this was the name of the song over here, To Each His Own. So I thought it was kind of cool, so I put it just on the edge right there. And then here's the back, and then the heel has the jute string on it. Oh, and then the bottom I put tissue paper on. It's like a harlequin. Use crepe paper to make a ruffle on the edge, and here's the crepe paper that I'm going to use, and I dip dyed it, and I'll show you how to do that real quick. You just take your piece of crepe paper, however long you want it, and you're going to just roll it, you know, into a like a paper, toilet paper roll or something like that, just tight, not too tight, but okay, all the way down until you get like this. And then I just took my Lindy Stamp Gang, I'm going to use a different color this time, I just squirted it in there like that, and then you just hold it in there until it soaks up all the dye. And then you turn it over and do the same thing on the other side and just let it soak it up. For as long as you can stand it. And of course, the longer you let it sit in there, the deeper into the middle it's gonna go. That's it, and then you can leave it like this for a while so it can soak down more into the middle, and then when you're done, you know, open it up to let it dry. And that's what I did with this one. And this one I used, you know, more of a, what did I use? I used the oh, here it is. I used the Treasure Island Turquoise, which is just like a, it's more of like a tea stain, and then just like a really super light shimmery turquoise. So now I'm going to fold it down. So I'm not going to fold it all the way in half. I'm just going to fold it so it makes like a double ruffle.
this. So basically to the top of where the other eye is. At the back of the shoe, fold your end in just a little bit to have a nice finished edge. I'm going to start here, and then I'm just going to glue it down. And then just, you know, make my ruffle and gluing along the way. So starting here. And then just making uniform. Or not. Little ruffles, little pleats along the way. And don't forget to glue down. So basically it's making a double ruffle without having to do it twice. So I finished the ruffle all around the shoe. And then here I took this dyed seam binding. Somebody gave me this in a rack, I believe, but oh, I can't remember who, sorry. But it's really cool. It's just a dyed crinkly seam binding. And I took my I've showed these before, but they're needles. They're made out, it's kind of like dental floss, but you can find them in the notions aisle in the sewing department, like Joann's, and you use it like you would thread the ribbon or seam binding, whatever you want to sew that's thicker, like this. And then I went in and out of the heart with the seam binding. I just stuck it through the nest and pulled it out and used this to sew with. So now I'm on the hunt for a little bird or something to put in there. Maybe I'll make him some little eggs. And then I'm gonna take this, it's like a crushed velvet ribbon, and I'm just gonna go around the edge like this. So I have my finished shoe here, and I left off with the velvet. So here's the crushed velvet after I put it all the way around, and I made this bow in the back. Just has these little tassels hanging down. And then I kind of just, you know, crunched it up around. I didn't want it to be super flat. And then I found a little birdie. It's a little porcelain bird. He's still a little small for the nest, but I like the way he looks in there. So, and then I just used some pearls for the eggs. So that's my shoe. And I hope Stephanie likes it. Thanks for watching, and thanks for putting up with the band.